So now let's switch over to electron backscatter diffraction, and I'm going to tell you about some of the newest developments in our EBSD software. So I'm going to focus both on data acquisition, our AZtecHKL platform, and data processing, our AZtecCrystal software. So the first thing I want to talk about is how we're making nanoscale EBSD easier. And this is done using transmission Kikuchi diffraction, which is essentially EBSD applied to electron transparent samples. And that gives us much better spatial resolution. So what we've done in AZtec is to introduce a dedicated TKD map navigator that leads the user step by step through this slightly modified process of collecting good quality TKD data. This is also incorporating our unique band detection algorithm that has been specially optimized for the unique geometry of TKD, so we get really good quality data all the time. And of course, it's coupled with the benefits of our symmetry S2 EBSD detector. So that's the speed, the sensitivity that comes with the fiber optics, and the fact that we can position the phosphor screen using our elevation control in the ideal position for any TKD analysis. So what this gives us is both high speed and, of course, the high spatial resolution or orientation mapping. So I'm going to show you briefly some example images from a deformed aluminium 6000 series alloy. On the left-hand side, we have a oriented dark field forescatter image. The field of view here is about 60 microns across. And up in the top right, we have the perforation on this electropolished foil, and we can see the nanostructured grain structure here. We're mapping this area shown with the yellow line, and this has been analyzed at a high speed. It's in effect a survey scan using a step size of 30 nanometers at a speed of about 750 index patterns per second. And then we identify a region that we want to analyze in a little bit more detail, and here we see a high resolution analysis. So the scale bar here is 2 microns, the step size 10 nanometers, and this is measured at a slower speed to get higher precision data, at about 123 patterns per second. We've also worked on improving the data that we can collect from 3D EBSD analyses. And one of the problems in such experiments is that we have shadows. The deeper we mill into the sample, the more likely it's going to be affected by shadows cast onto the edges of the phosphor screen. An example is shown now on the right-hand side, and what this does is it makes a mess of the standard band detection. So instead of picking out the Kikuchi bands in the pattern, it's picking out the edges of the shadowed region. So what we've introduced is a unique dynamic shadow masking tool that basically removes the effect of the shadows, gives us good quality diffraction patterns and reliable band detection, which in turn means high quality data. So as an example, this is taken from the final slice of a 3D EBSD experiment. This is the phase map. This is a heat-treated duplex stainless steel with intermetallics. This is collected without the shadow mask. And what we've done is reduced the area used for the band detection, but we still lose out on information at the sides of this phase map. Switch on the shadow mask, go to the normal band detection settings, and we can see much better quality data on the right-hand side. So this will improve the quality of any 3D EBSD experiment. And of course, it will also benefit the analyses of other rough samples, such as fracture surfaces or faceted crystals. Now let's move on to data processing, and the biggest new feature that we've introduced into AZtecCrystal is the reconstruction of parent microstructures. So this is for samples that have undergone displacive phase transformations, and that's primarily steels for austenite to martensite transformations, and of course titanium alloys and in the additive manufacturing sector where we get, for example, beta to alpha titanium transformation. By reconstructing the parent microstructure, it gives researchers a much better understanding of how the processing parameters need to be adjusted in order to ensure you get the desired final materials properties. So you can see on the right-hand side, this is an orientation map of a martensitic steel. And we can now reconstruct in AZtecCrystal the parent microstructure as shown on the lower right-hand side. So this is now the reconstructed face-centered cubic austenite microstructure. And this new tool will work on all displacive transformations. It's fast, it gives really reliable, high quality data, and it will also work on large-scale data sets at low resolution. So we've tested it on data sets up to 40,000 parent grains. Here's an example. This is an additively manufactured Ti64 alloy. This is the as-measured alpha structure. The field of view is just over 20 millimeters across. And this is the reconstructed high-temperature beta microstructure. And this data set was collected at low resolution in about half an hour. So you can see the power of this technique. The final feature I want to talk about is the use of electron images and the correlation with EBSD map data. So we often want to correlate our EBSD results to our electron images, but what we have with EBSD is commonly we get drift during the acquisition, and that causes distortion and means our EBSD data do not correlate perfectly with the underlying electron image data. So what we've introduced into AZtecCrystal is, first of all, the ability to display our electron image data and to give the EBSD overlay. So what we're seeing here is a forescatter image of a duplex stainless steel, and then we're overlaying the phase map. And you can see from the marked region of an intermetallic cluster that there's a discrepancy between the position of the two data sets. That's caused by drift during the analysis. So we've also introduced a powerful drift and distortion correction tool that makes sure that our EBSD data correctly correlates with the electron image data. So if we go to the same data set after applying this drift correction, you can see it's a perfect match between our phase map measured by EBSD and the underlying forescatter image. So this really opens a pathway to further correlative analyses, linking EBSD with other microscopy techniques and other imaging tools. Just as a little example, this is a recrystallized and formed nickel superalloy sample. We're looking at a forescatter image, which has got an overlay showing EBSD boundary data, high angle boundaries in blue, low angle boundaries in red. And then we're plotting the directions of the Burgers vectors using the yellow arrows. And it allows us this powerful correlative approach to EBSD in microscopy.